Integration into a predominantly white society has proven to be one of the biggest challenges faced by Black people in America. Black people have ruthlessly fought for equality in a country that systematically oppresses their freedoms. During the Civil Rights Movement of the 60s, we heard hopeful calls for change in the way Black men and women were treated. This video will analyze the Black man's burden, which is directed in the idea that Black men are not accepted into American society because of the negative stereotypes that have been placed upon them via media, social standards, and through the miseducation of dominant groups. Poetic genius Langston Hughes tackles the topic from a hopeful and enlightening perspective in his poem, I Too, written in 1925. Talented rap lyricist J. Cole takes us through his personal life of being targeted in his song, Neighbors. Langston Hughes begins his poem with the strong statement, I too sing America. The poem is told from the perspective of a Black man who was under a form of servitude to a white superior. This is evident in the line, I am the darker brother. They send me to eat in the kitchen when company comes. This reinforces that his Blackness was not good enough to be in the presence of white counterparts, and his status was not of an equal human being, but as a subordinate. The Black poet continues with a seamlessly positive and charismatic tone, using phrases such as, I laugh and eat well and grow strong and tomorrow, to assure his audience that he is not discouraged or dispirited by the bigotry that makes society see him as a meaningless object rather than a man who has ambitions and dreams. The poem is finalized with, besides, they'll see how beautiful I am and be ashamed. I too am America. Despite the speaker's negative circumstances and segregation to the kitchen to eat because of his skin color, he sees the greatness and potential in himself. Langston Hughes is prepared to sit at the table and join his white counterparts rather than eat in the kitchen. He prefers to integrate into the white dominant culture while J. Cole rejects the idea of him integrating into white society. This is the biggest difference between the two. J. Cole presents the modern day struggle of being Black in America in his song Neighbors. The rapper expresses his discontent and anger with the society he lives in. Cole wrote this song as a response to his neighbors reporting to the police that he was running a drug operation out of his home in suburban North Carolina. On a sunny afternoon, the SWAT team raided his home, which he uses as a place to produce his music, and they found nothing. Cole sets the scene using imagery to explain his neighborhood. He says, that's why I moved away. I needed privacy, surrounded by the trees and Ivy League, students that's recruited higher league. This implies that the people who live in this neighborhood are very wealthy and predominantly white. He also uses imagery to describe why he believes his neighbors thought he was a drug dealer. Cops bust in with the army guns, no evidence of the harm we done, just a couple neighbors that assume we slang, only time they see us we be on the news in chains. Cole offers insight on how media representation of Black male has negatively affected him. Because his neighbors had not been exposed to positive images of Black men, they automatically assumed that he was bad. Cole relents. So much for integration. Don't know what I was thinking. I'm moving back to Southside. By the end of the song, Cole has completely given up trying to fit in and live the American dream, and he leaves the listeners to believe that he would rather return to Fayetteville, North Carolina, his hometown, than live amongst people who despise him. The amazing silver lining between these two works of art is that they both see value in being male and being Black, regardless of what they are made to feel like by white social standards. This is confirmed in the poem by the speaker identifying as beautiful, and J. Cole being so satisfied with himself that he is prepared to give up the suburban house that represents wealth and status. Both artists achieved a me over them attitude, and this sets an overarching theme of self-love.